Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Cartesian Charts Control. Using the .NET MAUI Cartesian Charts, you can display and analyze data in a two-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system with customizable styles and interactive features. Now, I will show you how easy it is to add the Cartesian Charts control to the .NET MAUI application and bind data to it. I will also demonstrate how to initialize the chart axis and add a title, data labels, legend, and tooltips. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. Once you have installed the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and give a project name and location. Here, I'll proceed to create the project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now the project is ready. Before I move forward, let's take a quick detour to set up the environment for running our application. Here, I choose an Android emulator. For this demonstration, I will select the Pixel 5 Android emulator. Once the emulator is selected, I'll run the application and show you the default output. The application has started compiling the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. And now the application's homepage is displayed. Next, I will demonstrate how to incorporate a SyncFusion.NET MAUI Cartesian charts into this application. I open the NuGet Package Manager. Search for the SyncFusion MAUI charts package and install it in my application. It will take a few seconds to complete the installation, so let's wait. Once the package is installed, I navigate to the main XAML page and remove the default scroll view related code. Then import the SyncFusion MAUI charts namespace. And to the local XAML namespace, map the default project namespace, MAUI project. Now, initialize the control by adding the SF Cartesian chart tag. To locate the data points inside the chart area, I need to initialize the chart axis. I include the SF Cartesian chart x-axis property, and this chart supports numeric, category, date, time, and logarithmic axes. Now I add the category axis to plot the values based on the index of the data point collection. Then add the SF Cartesian chart y-axis property and use the numeric axis to plot the numeric values. Next, I need to register the SyncFusion Core Handler to map the cross-platform API to the native view API. So, open the MAUI program file and add SyncFusion MAUI Core Hosting. Then register the handler by adding the configure SyncFusion Core method. To use the SyncFusion MAUI controls, it's necessary to register a trial license key. I can do this by opening the app XAML CS file. Add the register license method and enter the trial license key. To find out where to generate the trial license key, refer to the description below. Then I press the F5 key to run this application. A basic Cartesian chart is rendered. Make sure your chart is rendered as such, then you have properly configured the control. In this example, I'm going to compare the heights of individuals in centimeters. So, I will proceed to add data points to the chart to see its basic layout. To demonstrate this, I'm going to use the MVVM pattern. First, I create a model class and name it Person. Now the class is created and made public. Then, I define the field Name with string type. And add another field Height with double type. I am going to assign values for these fields, so I need to create a ViewModel class. Add the new class and name it DataViewModel. Now the class is created, and I change it to public. Then, declare a bindable property Data. And add a constructor for this class. Inside this constructor, I initialize the data collection with the required number of objects. To bind this data object, I open the XAML page and add the SF Cartesian chart binding context property. Access the DataViewModel class here using this local XML namespace. To bind this collection, I need to specify the series type for the chart. I use the column series, as I'm going to render the column chart. Then assign the object collection to the item's source property. And map the data source field name to the X binding path property. And height to the Y binding path property. Now press the F5 key to run this application again. Check now, the column series with data points are rendered. The other available series in Cartesian charts are line, flat line, area, and scatter. Check the documentation link provided in the description to know more about these chart series. Now I'll move back to the example. Look at this chart, there is no clarity to the data being displayed. So, let's see how to add a title to the chart. I include the title property and define the text as comparison of heights. Then add the title property to the category axis. And define the chart axis title text as name. Also, add the title property to the numeric axis. And define the chart axis title text, height in centimeters. Look here, the title is displayed for the chart. And its axes are labeled. To identify the data points and enhance the readability of a chart, you can show the labels. Just enable the Show Data Labels property in the column series. See now, the labels are shown for each data point. Next, I will show you how to enable legends to show information about the series. I include the legend property and define the chart legend to enable it. Then in the column series, I add the label property and set its value to height. Check now, the legend is shown in the chart. Finally, I will show you how to enable the tooltip to display the additional information when you click a data point in the chart. To do that, set the Enable Tooltip property and set its value to true. Check now the tooltip is shown when I click a data point. Now let me quickly summarize what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add SyncFusion MAUI Cartesian chart control with a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use our .NET MAUI products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.